Good morning, world. It is 7:30 a.m. on June 4th. June 4th, 2018, in Northern California, just northeast of San Francisco. Again, I'm watching my cat look outside. But I just discovered a friend from Ireland has left me a message in Anchor's message box. And Paul O'Mahony has gone to my website and looked it over, I imagine, and has left me a reading of my own artist statement. And I thought, uh-oh. At first I thought, oh great, I'm going to hear all the flaws in it, and I'm going to hear how it doesn't make sense. But I was floored by his reading of it. I have never heard it out loud. In fact, I must say, I don't think I've ever read it aloud myself. Maybe to myself, you know, inside my brain, but not out in the world. Vocally, audio in a way that anyone else could hear it. Even my cats. I mean, I've never read it to my cats. So I'm going to see if I can record it here because it was really such a lovely reading of my own words, but in his language, in his Irish brogue, or his Irish accent. Let me try this, see if I can get it over here. And he has an introduction to why he's doing it. So I will just allow that to happen.
Robin, I've been to your website and I've read something you wrote. I've read your statement written in 2017. And I'm going to do something naughty or something bold. I feel because the word naughty and bold are synonyms in Ireland when I was growing up, and because there's the word bold in the UK means something different and it doesn't mean naughty, I'm going to use it in the UK sense, and I'm going to do something bold. A year ago in 2017, Robin T. Milnes said this, or wrote this: transitions are great opportunities for creating, and this year is no different. Seriously painting for 17 years, I'm embarking onto a new path in my work and life. Abstractions have always been important to me, and I'm currently painting a body of new work based on geographical spaces and places. Having a good foundation in colour and form, thanks to studying with Hung Liu, Anna Valentina Mursch, and Catherine Wagner at Mills College, I've been painting thematically for quite a while, creating series work. Now I want to concentrate on surface and materials, creating my content. Painting is not just about a statement on painting for me, even though the materials are seductive. Passionate about nature, I live and regularly walk near trees, rocks, and rivers and the sea. Organic organic shapes permeate my paintings. Layers of color and form make up the final finished work. Now, Paul O'Mahony just wants to interject one tiny thing. That sentence, passionate about nature, I live in, regularly walk near trees, rocks and rivers and the sea, reminds me of Mary Oliver, the poet. Having travelled out to California at the age of 3 from Louisiana, in the back seat of a station wagon, crossing wide open spaces, along with long drives into the mountains and rocky nooks of Santa Barbara, with my father exploring poppies, rocks and old caves, or moving from Southern California to Northern California as a young girl before high school, and crisscrossing the land in many states, especially Montana, Wyoming, and New Mexico as an adult. The geography has left lasting impressions of the land, its cracks, surfaces, juxtaposed with jutting cliffs, red tones and greens, and sky weather contrasts in different seasons. Recent travel has also left its impression. Most recently, the open lands of Denmark, with its big rolling skies, the sea, birds and wildlife. The Seine in France feels like home, as does Hurup, Denmark, where I found surviving family from my father's side, able to see the old farm and the forest my great-great-grandfather helped plant, are all fertile memories and imagery for my work. I don't set out to paint any particular landscape, but different harbours, reflections, shadows, tree growth, lizards, blue heron, pelicans, waves crashing, sands blown by wind across shore surfaces, and of course the rocks I find in these places all influence and inspire. All influence and inspire my work. Abstractions in my work tend to take on some sort of nature element or place. Paintings are a place for me to tell my story, and figures are not always absent. I am where I am. I hope the viewer will stand in my place and wonder where my brush and colour takes them. Robin Milne, 2017. And on the website, there is a photograph of Robin herself and one of her paintings. I want to thank Robin Milne for writing that. It's given me something luscious to brood on.
Well, Paul, you've outdone yourself with a surprise. So thank you for doing that. I've never heard my statement read aloud at all, ever. It was very nice of you to do that. And it's still appropriate for today. Those are the things I'm still doing in my work. So I guess I'm okay with that statement still being there. Sometimes I upgrade it a bit. But for today, onward I go into the studio to continue my painting on into those geographical spaces that I've been. The Denmark series is probably the largest body of work I've done on it in one place. Within that body of work is 9 different places and how I felt there. And I was just talking to my friend last night after the artist talk I went to, telling her that I would probably continue in that work because there's still more to say there. And yet, after hearing Brian Rutenberg talk about honing in on one part that your viewer might want to see and painting that. I tend to find that my figures do pop into the work because humanity is important to me, especially those in need. So my refugee series, the statement I'm making about how wars have ravaged countries and people, those paintings are popping back into my life. So those are going to continue as well. So you will see figures in those, but I'm trying to be very abstract in the way I present that story. Thanks again, Paul. That you have also made me brood a little bit on my own work and my own statement of my purpose here and what I'm doing in my work. So appreciate the call out here, and I will be posting this in my audio. You know, you also made me think it might be good to articulate my work audio, like in my art, you know, embed some audio with some of my pieces on my website so people could hear my voice talk about them. So you gave me another idea. Thank you so much.